In this segment, we'll take an example of the single application trapezoidal rule. So this is the example we're taking. We're asked to integrate a function which looks like this. We're asked to use the single application trapezoidal rule, find the true error, and find the absolute relative true error. So let's go and see how we can go about doing that. So we have this integral given to us. We already know that the formula for the single application trapezoidal rule is given as follows. For the general case, so in this case we have the values of a and b, 1.3 and 0.1. Then we're going to calculate the value of the function at 0.1. We're going to calculate the value of the function at 1.3. And we take the average value of those two. So this gives us 1.2. And this one is 0.1 times e to the power minus 2, 0.1, plus 1.3 e to the power minus 2, 1.3. Divided by 2, and this value here turns out to be as follows once you do the calculations. So this is what we get by using the single application trapezoidal rule as the value of the integral. Now let's go, this was part A. Let's go to part B, where we have to find the true error as well as the relative true error. To find the true error, we need the true value and the approximate value, which we just calculated in the previous part. The true value is given to us as 0.89387. And if you are interested in, you can find the true value by just doing integration by parts. And the approximate value we found out from the previous part was this. And this number here turns out to be 0.35858. Now, if we want to find the absolute relative true error, in that case, it will be the true error divided by the true value, absolute value of that. And if we calculate in terms of percentage, we'll multiply it by 100. So here we get this to be this quantity here, which we just found out. The true value is this quantity, and we'll multiply by 100, and we get a relative true error of 40.115%, which is huge, but you got to understand this is only a single application trapezoidal rule. And it's a little bit out of the ordinary because of the way the function behaves, because if you look at the way the function behaves, it's like this. This is your 0.1, and that's your 1.3. So you can see there's a lot of true error here. That's the approximate value, the shaded area here, like with the crosses. And this one is the true error. So that's why I was saying that in this example here, it's a little bit inflated. I should say call it inflated, but it is an out of the ordinary example that we're getting this much true error. And that's the end of this segment.